on 2K Sports. It's the Chicago Bulls facing the Indiana Pacers. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's check out who's on the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. So for Chicago right now, Harper's out there with Jordan. And it's Dennis Rodman. Then there's Pippen. And it's Longley in at the five, home in the paint. So the Chicago Bulls able to put up the first points on the board. Outside Jackson, he dishes it to Davis. Here's Rose. He can't get that one to fall. Now Chicago takes it the other way. Outside Harper. And Pippen with the basket. The assist from Ron Harper.
Not fazed at all by having a bigger defender on him down low. And I really thought he would be.
You know, at first glance, you wouldn't think that he'd be comfortable in that particular situation. But boy, I tell you what, he didn't look like he was out of his element at all right there.
Here's Jackson after the made shot from Scottie Pippen. Six to shoot. Here's Spitz. Nice form on the 20-footer.
Spitz!
And here is Harper. Down low. Longley passes to Jordan. And the Bulls tack on two more.
Talk about a great start. Three of three from the field to get the game going. They're cooking with gas, folks.
A little over a minute 30 into this first quarter. Here's the dish to Davis. Indiana moving the ball around. Here's Spitz. Leans inside. That one, no good. Now Chicago takes it the other way. Jordan kicks to Harper. Pass to Longley. And finished off by Longley.
Oh, inflicting some punishment with the two-hand flush.
They're going for the throat.
Now's the time to do it. Keep attacking that rim.
Now here's Jackson. Outside, Davis. Got his first bucket in this one.
And I tell you what, anytime you get those easy ones, that basket starts to get bigger.
That's for sure. Always want to get into that early rhythm and get the defense on its heels, and that way you open up your full repertoire of offensive options.
And folks, he does more than just put 2 points onto their lead. He does it with a little bit of flair.
He sure does. You're right. It's a dazzling move to the bucket for him.
I tell you what, he may not be the biggest man in the league, guys, but he more than makes up for that lack of size with amazing aerial skills.
Pippen with the bucket.
Just impressed with the teamwork out there, setting the table for one another.
Five straight baskets, Greg, resulting from assists. They're playing as one unit out there.
Now here is Davis. Miller outside. Rodman with the rebound. The Bulls leading by 8. Harper dishes to Pippen. Jordan kicks to Harper. With the floater. It's rebounded by Indiana.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job.
Yeah, good job to take it right at him.
Yeah, really left him no choice there, Greg. He had the foul and keep converting the easy bucket.
And so Jackson nails both of them. First quarter play and just over 3.5 minutes in. That's going to be over and back. Back watching to the line that time. Davis, the pass to Rose. Here's Smits. Outside Rose. Davis dishes to Miller. And that one falls, coming off of Davis's feed.
Oh, that is just weak defense there. I'm pretty sure that was not the plan to give him those kind of baskets at the hoop.
Well, I tell you, that really sets a bad tone, especially this early. I mean, I'd rather see him commit a hard foul than give him an easy two like that. Show that you're willing to protect the basket. Make him
earn it at least.
And this is why you need good defenders on the interior to contest shots.
Yeah, Greg, making every shot a hard one, even the shots in close, presents a defender with a serious challenge, always.
Here's Harper, the Pacers making the shot. Now the pass to Long, and the layup's good off the glass.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
10 straight points off assist, that's very impressive, and it also makes the game easy and fun to watch.
Now here is Miller. Goes up on the top of the key. Jackson passes to Smits. Takes the three. And there's Jackson on the assist by Miller. Jackson's got 5 points so far.
And they can't allow him too many open looks like that. That's just inviting trouble.
Rodman with a screen on Jackson. Feeds it to Rodman. Back to Harper. Rodman sets a screen. Lock at six. Harper against Jackson. No good on the triple. Indiana trailing here. Dishes it to Miller. Passes it to Smits. Out to the right wing. Rose against Harper. Miller, the pass to Smits. Shoots from the block. It's stolen by Rodman. In transition, here come the Bulls. Here's Jordan. And it's Smith with the rebound. Jackson with it. He's got five. He kicks it to Miller. Shoots the three. Doesn't go that time. Now Chicago takes it the other way. Here's Rodman. And Davis pulls it down. Here's Indiana. They trail by one. Miller with a wide open look. Up again. It's hauled in by the Bulls.
Yeah, that's a tough call right there. And really a tough break for the D.
Greg, no problem for me with that call.
Way to work, gentlemen. Let's go now. Hustle up.
Envision yourself as a coach as well. So, you know, sometimes you need to make some adjustments.
Now here's Pippen. Puts it up from 12. That one's a miss. His third shot of the game. He's made one of them. And up the court come the Pacers on the break. Smits. And they call over the back here. Too much contact.
Yeah, not afraid of the physical play, but he's still needs to stay under control.
Yeah, he obviously was not under control right there. Not much doubt he was going to get whistled for the over-the-back call.
Chicago leading. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Thank you, Kevin. I caught up with the Bulls head coach. He said the key to this game is how much they can limit the quality looks inside. He said when you're playing a team like this, you don't stand a chance if you give them easy shots down low. We'll see who wins that battle, Kevin.
Thank you, David. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Jackson kicks to Miller. And there's the feed to Davis. Pass to Rose. Just five to shoot. And good. That game was that time as it falls.
Wow, he was just wide open there. That's way too easy.
Jordan dishes to Harper. Against Pippen. Harper's shot's good. Harper's got 6 points.
Shots are just flowing. Him right now having a really strong quarter.
Outside Jackson. Miller, the pass to Smits. Back to Miller. Plays it up and picks it in. 6 points for him.
Hey, how about the burst in that first step? Just right to the rim.
Now Pippen. He has six, and the shot goes down.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
You know, the defense, Greg, has really been kept off balance because of the outstanding passes. Four straight field goals have been made off an assist.
From the high post, rebounded by Rodman.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Well, I don't think there's any question about it. They came focused and ready to play. I mean, they're doing everything they can to put things in their favor. You earn that, and they're actually earning it well right now.
And so here is Indiana. After the Bulls pick up two, Davis kicks to Miller. In transition, here come the Bulls. Harper with the ball. Guarded now by Jackson. It's deflected. Down low, Smith. And there's the dunk that pass it off.
Oh, and how about squeezing the orange as tight as he could there before the stop?
Yeah, no way he's going to lose that thing on the way up.
Better safe than sorry, right?
Here's Harper, the Pacers making the shot. Smith with the rebound.
Not a good pick there. If I'm shooting the ball and I'm looking at him, I'm asking, where is the effort? You've got to do a better job of screening.
Now here's Jackson. 5 points in the game. Shots good by Miller. And it's now only a 1 point Bulls lead. Miller's gone 50% shooting tonight, firing away 4 of 8. Harper kicks to Jordan. Rodman with a screen on Rose. To the paint. Goes up.
Oh! Ooh, that kind of defense, it's almost as if they're just standing there.
Well, for the most part, they were just standing still. And you've got an easy 2 points.
And you know what, Kevin? He's not the most explosive player on the court. But if you give him a clear lane to the basket, he'll punch it on you.
Special thanks to Kia for that sweet Kia Slam Cam replay. Stolen. Kicks to Miller. 1:25 left in the first quarter. Davis dishes to Jackson. Over to the left wing. Just 5 to shoot. And it's Smith's missing. Chicago leading by 3. Harper kicks to Jordan. Fires from the wing. No good on that one. So the Pacers will take it the other way. Miller, the pass to Davis. And the powerful one-handed slam.
And guys, he's not an easy man to stop. He's got the rim in his sights.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher.
And guys, I like the fact that...
Here he comes, and there he goes.
Look at him punish that rim.
Boy, the guys on the bench loving every minute of that one.
30 seconds left in the first quarter, and the wide-open shot from Rose. It's good, the assist this time from Jackson. Jackson's got his third assist on the night. 19 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Here's the dish to Rodman. Jordan inside. He's guarded by Davis. The shot's good from Jordan. Jordan's got 8 points.
You know, huge height advantage there, but because of the great body control, he's able to cancel it out.
Agreed. The body control is essential in that situation. I mean, if you've given up a bunch of height, then you better be able to manufacture things in the air.
Welcome back, folks. We have a close game here at the start of the second quarter of play. Guys, what's your take on the Bulls so far?
I just really like what we're seeing from a defensive standpoint, forcing a lot of turnovers with those quick hands.
Yeah, those active hands, Greg, have produced a number of steals early. They've been very aggressive.
On the court right now, second quarter for the Bulls. Simpkins is out there with Bill Wennington. And their
first Buechler, then it's Kerr, and it's Kukoc in at the threesome. Here's Wenningsen, and it's Schmidt with the rebound. Rose dishes to Davis, and it's good. Through contact, gets the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
Good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Time dropping delights is what I call it.
That is a nice pass. I will give you that one.
Yeah, he's on the money. That's no doubt. Bulls trail by three. Goes up high for the two-handed dunk.
And that's how it's done. I mean, find that hole in the D and then go hard to the rack.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
Well, it was. I mean, a tight game like this one, you'd think they'd have a little more energy at the defensive end than that.
Jackson kicks to Miller. So he gets the whistle. Jack on the way up, and two shots coming up.
Some good numbers there for Miller. He has 11 points, and he's put one three-pointer on the board.
You know what, though, Clark? It wouldn't be a bad idea going forward to try to let him do a little more damage from beyond the arc.
And a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for Indiana.
Guys, they are dialed in from beyond right now. They didn't waste any time getting into a groove in this game.
They've established their presence in the paint tonight. Also, a lot of their scoring to this point coming from down low.
Mullins checked in for the Pacers. And good on the second, so he makes them both.
He's a dead eye at the line, fellas. Just call him automatic. He doesn't miss many of those.
Davis with the double team. Kerr, the pass to Simpkins. Back to Kerr. Shoots off the screen. And that one hits back iron. Pacers leading by three. And the pass to Buechler. Back to Kukoc. And here in the second, with about a minute and a half gone by, Kerr dishes to Kukoc. And Davis sends it back. Huntington. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. It's his first trip to the line. And the first one at the line is good. And he makes both free throws.
And it's been a really good day for him at the line. Some other bigs have well-documented problems on their free throws. He's not one of them.
Outside Jackson. Miller, right side. There's the pick. Outside Mullen. And out of bounds as the Bulls gain possession.
That is just a careless turnover. You've got to be smarter in those exchanges.
Now here's Kukoc. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. That one goes. Count it.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Pass to Mullen. There's the three. Oh, and he parks it off the glass. Wow. And that's out of bounds. Indiana will retain possession. Rose, he's checked in for the Pacers. The Bulls making a change here as well. Brown, he's checked in for Kerr. Jackson misses.
I didn't see that miss coming. I mean, he's usually been money from that range.
Brown against Jackson. He hits Brown with the drive. Outside, Kukoc. Bulls moving the ball around. Down to five on the shot clock. Brown the pass to Wennington. Right wing, Simpkins. No good on the three.
Definitely a situation you want to make sure you don't give him too good of a look.
And so he draws the foul on the shot. Now trip to the line to shoot two.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
Yeah, the officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious.
And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for Chicago.
And so far, these guys have done a fantastic job finding the open man and getting some easy baskets.
You know, we've seen them bearing their fair share of mid-range jumpers tonight, too. I mean, that's a good start for them.
and he sinks the second. About 3 minutes played so far in the second quarter. To the inside, here's Brown. Count the bucket, coming off a perfectly placed assist.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Best passes to Davis. And it's Davis finishing it off.
An aggressive move and fantastic finish.
Trying to send a message with that slam, I think.
That's exactly how you send it. Two hands and down.
Against Kukoc, and lots of contact there, missing the shot, he'll shoot two. The Bulls have gone 2 for 2 in the game at the line. And the first one at the line is good. Kukoc hits them both.
Yeah, nice job of drawing the contact and creating opportunities at the line.
My kind of hoops. Straight ahead, playing downhill, and physical.
Here's Smits. That's in, and that's his fourth basket of the night. Taking 7 shots, a solid 57%.
And just a nice combination of size and feel there. Terrific finish down low.
It's Brown with the drive. Here's Simpkins. The shot's good. Brown making the play. Simpkins got his second bucket.
And can you always depend on him or what to lead you to the right place with that pass? Money.
Perkins with the screen. Feeds to Mullen. Launches a three. Sinks the three-pointer. Mullen's got 4 points this quarter.
He just sagged off just enough and no hesitation on his part.
Kukoc kicks to Brown. They're running at the floor. Here's Mullen. The rebound by Simpkins.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
Out to the wing. Dishes it to Kukoc. No good that time. And Indiana will go the other way with it. Best passes to Rhodes. Oh, and then hit by Rhodes.
Oh, going high to throw that one down.
Sky high. Fantastic one-hand jam.
Nice way to punctuate that possession.
Time call here. The Bulls decide.
Bring it in. Take a seat.
Things that can be improved and wants to get everybody back on the same page.
And usually that, to me, is a good use of the timeout. I mean, if there's something that he's noticed that can give his team a lift, I think he's got to try to take advantage of that.
The Pacers making a switch here. Miller's checked in. Tries to keep it alive. And they're moving it up. On up the court. Here's Best. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. That one on Kukoc.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
No question about it, Greg. I mean, a ton of contact and a good call by the officials.
That misses, so he splits the free throw. Bulls trail by 4. Pull up Jay. Gets some rim on the way in, and the bucket's good. Here's Best. He feeds it to Miller. A 3. Chicago grabs the miss. Over in the corner, Brown.
He's jammed himself up a little bit here with that second foul. As long as he can avoid a third before the half, I think he's fine.
The Pacers making a switch here. Jackson's checked in. The screen from Brown. Smith with the rebound.
That was a half-hearted pick. And he was just going through the motions on that possession, and now it ends up costing him. No one to blame on that one but himself. You get looks like that, you've got to take advantage.
Miller, the pass to Smith. Kukoc with the defensive effort.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
from 13. And no good that time. And Indiana will go the other way with it. And here's Jackson. 5 points in the game. Miller outside. Here's Schmitz. And he throws it in for the dunk.
Offensive rebound, a big part of what makes this guy special.
Not to mention, Greg, his ability to finish with strength just like that.
Yeah, he's an invaluable asset for them to have, no question about it.
Bushler, and Miller with the block. Outside Jackson. Outside Mullen. A 19-foot shot. Here's Schmitz, and he goes in strong with one hand and flushes it down.
And just another example, Kevin, of how they built this lead, just outworking.
Now, Greg, that was definitely an effort play right there. You talked about that all the time, fighting to get proper position and slamming home the putback.
Yep, and if they can maintain this energy level, their lead will be safe.
And it's all about the release when you shoot the floater.
On the wing, Miller. And it's good off the back of the rim and in. Miller's got 7 now in this quarter. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Here's Kukoc. Falls through. He's now made 2 of 4.
And I like the fact that he really was unfazed by that scoreless first quarter. And now you can see him getting into a rhythm.
To the middle. Got a piece of it. Kukoc with the steal. Oh, and a fast break for the Bulls. The fast break ends at the rim with a jam.
Yeah, how about the sharp steal and then run out? It looks like they're ready to put the hammer down.
Well, we've been waiting for one of these teams, Greg, to pull away. Maybe that'll be a springboard for them.
Could be. A dunk like that coming off a great defensive play has to build some momentum.
Here's Schmitz. Gonna go that time, and the Bulls going the other way now. Guys, a potent offense right now.
You know what, guys, and they're playing with a certain amount of assurance in their game. That type of confidence is what leads teams to having success.
Bulls shooting their 5th and 6th free throws of the game. First free throw is good. Rose is checked in for Mullen. And it's tied up with that one. Jackson with it. He has 5. To the paint, off the screen, and he comes off the screen and slams it through.
Kevin, he is tough to stop when he gets to the rim.
Yeah, Greg, he can get up a few notches higher.
Well, and that's exactly how the game is played in the paint inside, guys. I mean, if you can play over the top, I think you've got a big advantage.
Here's Rose. So the whistle blows on the shot, and 2 free throws for the contact right there. For Indiana, they have shot 67% from the line, going 6 of 9. Free throw drops for Rose.
Well, a good one here for Rose. He has 8 points, and he's chalked up 1 3-pointer on the day as well.
And Clark, I'm sure that won't be the last one. A lot of times, he can get hot and stay hot from beyond.
Harper against Jackson. And now, running up the court, Miller pushing it up. Got that one up to it. Miller's got the lead up to 6 now for the Pacers. These guys have had some good motion on offense. Nice assistant.
And when everyone's involved offensively, it has a way of helping you on the defensive side as well.
Bulls shooting their 7th and 8th free throw attempts for the game right here. And he knocks down the first one.
And working, Kevin, themselves to the line here in the second. A nice way to get your offense going.
And maybe cause some foul trouble along the way as well. We know what that can do. It pays off typically in good fashion for you.
The Bulls making a switch here. Nippins checked in. Outside Rose. He dishes it to Miller. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Here's Jackson. Good as a finish through the hoop. Jackson's got 7 points.
Yeah, quick trigger. And from that range, if he senses the defenders have backed off, forget about it.
Here's Pippen. And the rebound goes to the Pacers.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good look. Forget about finesse. It is all about the power.
Bulls trail by 9. There's 1:26 left to play here in the half. Yep, that one goes in there.
And bullseye with that assist. Nice delivery there in traffic.
Jackson against Harper. Outside Jackson. Passes it to Perkins. Three-pointer. Rebound by Pippen.
Boy, even though he missed, you can't give up that kind of a look very often.
The better to be lucky than good sometimes. Fortunately, they didn't get burned on that one.
Pacers leading by 7. There's 45 seconds left in the first half of basketball. To the left side wing. And out of bounds is Chicago gains possession.
And that's just carelessness there. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
Davis has checked in for Indiana. Harper kicks to Jordan. Screened by Longley. Pippen, the pass to Longley. The basket drops and gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
How about battling through the impact there and then willing that basketball over?
Boy, it does your heart good to see that kind of determination in a player. Really excellent focus that time.
Mullins checked in for Miller. The Bulls making a change here as well. Kurtz checked in. Jackson dishes to Mullen. Dennis Rodman pulls it in. Rodman's got his third rebound on the night.
You know, he's been off his game this quarter just a bit. Hasn't been able to get a whole lot to go so far.
Perkins. No good. And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. Start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. Pacers leading by 5. Rose is out there with Perkins. Then there's Jackson. Then it's Mullen. And it's Davis at the center position. So that's the group out there for Indiana. And they call over the back here. Too much contact.
Yeah, no doubt about that one with the over the back call.
Yeah, it looked like he wanted to take him for a ride right there. Easy call.
That one goes in.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last 3 field goals have come from the paint.
Perkins with a screen on Harper. Pass passes to Perkins. The kick out to Rose. Davis sets a screen. And they're going to drop the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a 3-point play.
Been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons they're up in this game.
And Indiana making a change here. Harrington's checked in. Pacers have attempted 11 free throws today and converted 8 of them. Bulls trail by 6. Now Harper. Pass to Longley. It's Chicago with another bucket.
I love how he used his height advantage on that shot.
And he had the nice soft touch with it, too.
Rose hits to Harrington. Indiana moving it around. And it's good. 2 points.
Terrific effort on that shot. I mean, he's given up a lot of inches in that mismatch.
Well, height, who cares about height? I mean, it's just a number. Hey, you got to go with what you got. And he took what he had right at him there.
Longley, good for another bucket. He's made half a dozen now, 6 for 8 on the night.
And guys, the D has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that trip.
And the basket by Harrington.
And they continue to control the glass.
Guys, I
think they've simply been the more physical team, and that's why they're ahead.
Here's Harper. 6 points for him. He kicks it to Rodden. Here's Jordan. The shot misses. And Indiana will come the other way.
Yeah, but they're 3 of 4 to start the second half.
Harrington with a screen on Harper. Outside Mullen. Now the feed to Davis. Kicks it to Rhodes. A 15-footer. That's in there. Davis with the assist. Rose has got 14 points for the game. Bulls trail by 8. Now here's Pippen. He's got 8. They get a hand on it. It's stolen by Rose. It's tipped. There's the pass to Bex. The dish to Mullen. Just find the shoot. Fast break. Here comes Chicago. Outside Harper. Offside Pippen. Right side Jordan. Hands the shot with nobody near him. He's got 10.
Oh, wow. 4 of 5 to start the half. Coming out on fire.
Best passes to Rhodes. Davis dishes to Rhodes. And finish off by Rhodes.
That's his forceful finish as you're never going to see out of this guy.
Well, gee, it adds now to their lead in spectacular fashion.
And you know, that lead's only going to grow if they're not prepared to defend a little more staunchly than that.
Little under 2.5 minutes off the clock now here in the third. They set the screen. No good from Jordan.
Not a good pick there. If I'm shooting the ball and I'm looking at him, I'm asking where is the effort? You've got to do a better job of screening.
And here we go. The Bulls first break.
Tell you what, that was all made possible by the heads-up defense at the other end.
And I love that as soon as they get their hands on the basketball, they immediately get out.
And that's how we play the game. Bring it in. Let's go. Hey, we're in great shape.
A time here to talk things over is a smart idea.
One of the things you want to do is make sure everybody is clearly on the same page with the game plan. And sometimes you need a timeout to make sure that's the case.
Simpkins, he's checked in for Luke Long. And the dunk by Jordan.
Well, they won't be down for long if they can get some more early offense just like that.
And, Clark, the best way to get that early offense is with steals. That allows you to get out of transition.
Jackson kicks to Miller. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot 2. And look at how the hustle game has been going for the Pacers.
We've seen them make the extra effort from a defensive standpoint, closing out airspace and sending shots back.
You know, one other area they're doing well in is steals. I mean, they've knocked the ball loose a number of times and been able to track it down after the fact.
Both free throws good for Miller. Bulls trail by 6. Outside Harper. Pass to Jordan. Passes it to Simpkins. To the paint. And Kenneth Rodman with the slam.
Oh, and he went for the two-hander on the slam. Using some muscle.
Some urgency from him there. Sure.
I get the feeling, guys, that he may be sensing that this is a critical time in this game.
Pass to Smits. Indiana again missing. Now the Bulls with it. Outside Harper. The pass to Simpkins. Good ball movement here by the Bulls. No good from Jordan. Pacers leading by 4. points for him. Pass to Smits. From 10 feet out, Indiana again missing. Jordan with. Now Harper, 8 points for him. Outside, Rodman. Here's the screen. 5 to shoot. And he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down. 6 points for him.
Make it 10 of their last 12 points coming off assists.
You have to love the ball move.
Here's Jackson. Rodman with the defensive effort.
And this is why you need good defenders on the interior to contest shots.
Yeah, Greg, making every shot a hard one, even the shots in close.
And taking care of the ball has been a problem for them.
That's something they've got to fix. While the defense has been good, a lot of these turnovers have been unforced.
Feeds to Miller. Inside. Indiana needs to get a shot off. It's stolen by Rodman. Miller against Jordan. Chance there to take the lead. Missing. Jackson against Harper. Dishes to Rhodes. Shot to stop the drought. It's good. The assist this time from Jackson. Jackson's got assist number 7 for him tonight. Chicago trailing here. Here's Harper. He's got 8. Down low. Stolen by Jackson. Here's Smits. And he drops in the layup off the glass. And the Pacers lead by 4.
Huge hole in the defense that possession. He didn't waste any time cutting through it.
Outside, Rodman. To the inside, Simpkins. Powered down after the assist, let him into the lane.
Oh, just solid on the one-handed slam.
And guys, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball.
Somebody you can count on. He is an extremely reliable finisher.
Okay, two hands for safety. That's what they say, right?
That's right. He was ultra safe with that dunk, no question.
And he should be. I mean, remove all doubt. Get it down hard and simple.
Hey, this is what happens when we play our brand of basketball. They cannot stop us. Don't quit until the final buzzer goes off. Let's finish this and go home.
Some changes for Chicago. Kukoc, he's checked in for Simpkins. And Steve Kerr is subbed in for Ron Harper. Bulls trail by 4. Outside, Kukoc. Rodman sets a screen.
Side out.
Jordan, the screen. Rodman passes to Kukoc. And so he draws the foul on the shot and trip to the line to shoot 2.
Well, Tony Kukoc in this one, he has 8 points. He's come up with a couple of nice steals today, too.
Well, just a very energetic brand of defense.
Now the feed to Miller. Over to the wing. 6 on the shot clock. Goes up the baseline. Here's Davis, and Davis throws it down.
The defense just gets caught standing around that time and giving up the second chance opportunity.
You know, that just can't happen. They need much more effort than that on the glass.
Covered by Miller. The Pacers pull it in.
Solid job by them on the glass here tonight. +8 in rebound.
You know what? That rebound has always been a perfect element of the game, and that's why they are now understanding how to win.
The screen play worked ideally there, and I'm not talking about the screen play you see in a movie theater. Gave him more than enough room to get that shot off.
Here's Kerr. Another shot. And Jackson with the block. And they're able to recover. Davis setting the pick for Jackson. Miller kicks to Jackson. Shoots it up. And the bucket counts. He's on his way to the free throw line. Trying to make it a three-point play.
Well played right there. There's no question who has the momentum.
Greg, the lead appears to be heading north, if you will.
Bulls making a switch here. Longley's checked in.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Yeah, they've not missed a single foul shot this half. That's taking care of business, fellas.
Outside Jordan. 8 for 15 with that made basket. But he's not satisfied yet.
He just exudes a love of the game, guys. You can see it in everything he does. This guy lives and breathes the game.
Jackson dishes to Miller. He feeds it to Davis. And Kerr pulls it down.
And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The D out of position, you could see the frustration on his face.
Jordan with the bucket.
No doubt about it. He has done a ton to help his team, but he's going to have to do even more if they want to have a chance to get back in this one.
Jackson kicks to Miller. And stolen by Jordan. Fast break. Here comes Chicago. Kicks it out to Kerr. Jordan, the pass to Longley. And the shot is good. Now just a 5-point Pacer lead.
And that's almost automatic anytime he can get the ball in that position.
Here's Jackson. Easy layup after coming off the pick. Jackson's got 4 points this quarter.
Give an assist there, not for the pass, but for the solid screen set on the inside that freed him up and made the layup possible.
Oh, dynamic two-hand jam.
Mm-hmm. And right in the face of the defender.
Yeah, that was a tough, gritty, sandpaper-like finish.
There's 48 seconds left in the third. 6 on the shot clock. Indiana moving it around. On the corner. And it comes off the front of the rim. Bulls trail by 5.
A chance here to go 2 for 1.
Boy, they've got to ramp up the speed and make it happen in a hurry.
Jordan kicks to Kukoc. He dishes it to Kerr. Miller against Jordan. Back to Kerr from downtown. Offensive rebound. Jordan the pass to Long. Rodman dishes to Kukoc. Kerr kicks to Rodman. Passes it to Kerr. Outside Rodman. A 3-ball. No good on that last second attempt there. Started. And Chicago has possession. It's a 5-point game. So for Chicago right now, Jordan is out there with Harper. Then it's Longley. Then it's Rodman. And it's Pippen in at the 3, the small forward.
Moving it around. 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
And Greg, you know nothing makes a coach happier than selflessness on the basketball court.
Here's Smith. Through traffic and lays it in. He's got 22.
Really, the defense is helpless to stop the layup right there. Just too much of an advantage in terms of the mismatch.
Left side, Jordan. He kicks to Pippen. Rob. And here we go. Yes, the shot is good. Now it's a 7-point Pacer lead.
And that's how the coach would draw it up on the fast break from start to finish.
Yeah, and what a finish it was, guys. Really nicely done.
Here's Pippen. It's deflected. And they're pushing it up. Outside Mullen. That's the bench. Inside. Stolen away. And here we go. The Bulls. Fast break. And here they go. Foul called that time.
doesn't have. He has 8 points, and the assist numbers tremendous.
His court vision is on par with anybody. I mean, he could not pass the ball any better than he is right now.
And he sinks the second. Pacers leading by 6. We've gone about a minute and a half into the fourth quarter. And they're running. Here is Longley, and he battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket.
And the rebound and the follow show you what he is all about. Gritty and determined with the soft touch to match.
Best passes to Perkins. Charity stripe shot off the left rim and up. Bulls trail by 4. Harper dishes to Pippen to the inside. Longley. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Bulls will retain possession. Here's Pippen. And up the court come the Pacers on the break. Rose kicks to Perkins. Mullen for 3. Hits the 3-point bomb. The Pacers lead by 7.
It's as if the defenses have just given up.
Yeah, you know, the Pacers only picked up the deeper we've gotten into this game, which is remarkable. It speaks to the endurance and stamina of these teams. And it's also been a lot of fun to watch.
That is just a careless turnover. You've got to be smarter in those exchanges.
There's a screen. Here's Best. Bounces high off the rim and drops. And it's a 9-point Indiana lead.
And that set them apart today, guys. Their success with the mid-range.
Simply taking advantage of what the defense has given them, and they've really made the most of it.
And really, nothing like a good old-fashioned throwdown to get a team going.
And, Greg, they do need to get going. They wouldn't mind, you know, shaving a couple more points off that lead right away.
Well, if the defense keeps giving up easy baskets like that, it won't be a lead for long.
At the line for your Pacers.
And he can't get the first one.
Taking 2 shots.
And he's good on the second.
Yeah, good job bringing that free throw percentage up here in the second half. Doing a great job at the line.
Stolen by Rose. The pass to Best. Some nice passing here by Indiana. Mullen's shot is off.
Just not there from a rhythm standpoint right now. It's really eluding.
A shot by Jordan, no good. Indiana leading by 8. And out of bounds as Chicago gains possession.
No clue where that pass was going. That is a brutal turnover.
Over 3.5 minutes through the final quarter now. At the teardrop, and the whistle blows as the basket counts. A 3-point play chance right here. One free throw coming up.
Shooting one.
What a play there. The hoop plus the harm.
Yeah, great concentration there, Greg. Hung in there. He didn't let that contact throw him off at all. Stayed focused on the rim. Knew he was going to get hit, and still was able to finish.
Right side, Rose. Back to Mullen. Kicks to Perkins. Shot clock at 5. A miss. Rodman's got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. Outside Jordan. There's the dish to Harper. Back to Jordan. Outside Pippen. Out left of the wing. Baseline Jay on the way. Longley can't get it to go. Pacers leading by 5. Here's Best. Here's Perkins. And the Pacers can't get it to go. It's stolen by Mullen. And here they come. to Rose. Perkins with a screen on Pippen. Here's Rose. That doesn't go either for Rose.
Good pick, but he just couldn't make it count.
Yeah, nice job of setting the screen by his teammate there. And I'm sure he appreciated it.
Knocked loose. It's stolen by Mullen. Here we go, one-on-one. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
Clearly a foul.
Yeah, he took a shot there. Earned those free throws.
And one difference this half is that when they get to the line, they're converting.
And some changes here for the Pacers. Davis comes in for Perkins. And Miller's subbed in for Mullen.
And as a team, they're hovering around the high 80s from the free throw line. They've gotten better as the game has gone along, which is exactly what you want to see.
Longley, a screen on Davis. Rodman passes to Jordan. From about 16. Doesn't go for him. So the Pacers will take it the other way. They've led by as many as 11 points. Inside. And the dunk to finish it off.
Oh, he just punches that one down with a fury. He
rubs it in a little deeper with the hanging finish.
Guys, they're not backing off at all, are they?
Pippen dishes to Jordan. To the middle. Here's Longley. And Davis pulls it down. Davis has got his 8th rebound here tonight. To the inside, the 10-footer, and the shot is good, helping in out the front of the rim. And now it's an 11-point Pacer lead. Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over.
Yeah, you can see they gave up a lot of points here in this run. He just wants to break the momentum before this thing gets out of hand.
And, you know, that's a huge part of a coach's job, making sure to keep your guys in the best position possible at all times. So I like this timeout.
He gets a chance now to catch up with the 4th member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, I was able to listen in on what the Bulls coach was going over with his team. He is not happy with the sloppy play offensively. He said, make the easy play. Take care of the ball. We can't afford to just give away golden opportunities. And we'll see if they can clean it up, guys.
Good on the second free throw. Pacers leading by 10. Now here's Jackson. Feeds it to Miller. Here's Mullen. Good. And Miller gets the assist.
Didn't have any problem knocking that one down. Another defensive lapse leading to 2.
Jordan kicks to Rodman. Back to Jordan. Outside for Pippen. Just 5 to shoot. Good for another field goal. Number 5 in the night. 5 for 10 shooting.
Oh, such a field shot there. The floater.
Outside Jackson. And stolen by Jordan. Last break. Here comes Chicago. And then Pippen slams it in.
And that's the classic 1-2 punch right there. I mean, nice steal. And then how about the elevation, Kevin, on the finish?
And Greg, nothing spurs some quick offense like a great play defensively.
That indicates the importance of great on-the-ball defense, as was displayed right there.
And the highlight reel replay brought to you by Kia. Good stuff on that Kia Slam Cam. Miller, the pass to Smith.
Even from over here, you can see that one pretty clear.
No question about it, Greg. I mean, a ton of contact and a good call by the officials.
And that one misses.
Taking 2 shots.
He hits the second from the line. Bulls trail by 9. Down low, here's Rodman, and Dennis Rodman with the slam.
And for a power forward, he can sure get up. I mean, because of that leaping ability, it kind of offsets his height disadvantage.
Outside Jackson. Dishes it to Miller. Shot by Post. Rebound by the Bulls. Pippen kicks to Jordan. Rebound to Jackson.
Well, he gets it in close, but you have to credit that stifling defense for forcing the miss.
Exactly, Greg. I mean, defense like that really increases the degree of difficulty on that shot by a large amount.
Is it me, or does it just feel like he gets every rebound that comes up?
Well, he practically has gotten every one that's available. A 20-plus rebounding game is not something we get to see very often, Greg.
They set the pick. To the middle. Looking for Mullen. He gets it there. Back to Jackson. Five on the clock. Offensive rebound. Smith passes to Jackson. And right through it goes.
Jackson!
And the Pacers lead by nine. Here's Chicago. Pippen is double. Outside Harper. Pippen against Mullen. Pulls it from the elbow. Again, the miss by Pippen. Pacers leading by nine. And here's Jackson. And here's Miller outside. Miller with another miss.
For the pick, with that weak screen, I use that term loosely. He had nothing to spring him open. It was ineffective.
Rodman sets a screen. Off the pick. And there's Jordan. That's good on the assist by Pippen. Pippen's got his eighth assist here tonight. And so it's Indiana with it. Outside Jackson. Here's Jackson. Kicks it out to Mullen. Goes up again.
Take a look at the performance in this one for Jackson. He's got 13 points and 7 assists.
And with the ball in his hands, he's made terrific passes. But also, when he's gotten to the line, he's been consistent as well.
Yeah, I like that combination, guys. I mean, going to make your coach happy when you're getting it done in those areas. Taking care of the ball, finding your teammates, and then knocking down free throws. Those are winning things.
We've got 1:48 left in the game. Passes it to Smith. Out to Miller. Miller with another miss. Bulls trail by 7. 3, Pippen. That drops and it comes off an assist from Jordan.
Big time bucket there. And you can expect to see him stay very involved the rest of the way.
Well, I agree with you wholeheartedly there. I mean, this is one guy who just does not know how to back down. Especially when the game's on the line.
Really the best result they could hope for on that possession. They get back all 3 points they just gave up and are close to putting this thing out of reach.
I'm not quite ready to go there yet, Greg, but it certainly sounds like the crowd is with you on that idea.
Baseline try, and it's Smith with the rebound. Pacers leading by 7. Here's Miller, and he banks in the lane.
Terrific run to seal the deal.
Yeah, and now let's just keep an eye on how much longer they keep the foot on the accelerator.
Here's Jordan. Lets it go from the baseline and nails it.
That's how to orchestrate for your teammate. Terrific pass.
There's 48 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And stolen by Jordan. In transition, here come the Bulls. Harper the pass to Long. Good! Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5.
You always hear about chemistry. That's a perfect example, knowing where each other is at all times.
Davis in the corner. And they go to the intentional foul.
Shooting for Indiana.
First free throw is good, and that increases their lead to 6. And so both free throws are good. And it's a 7-point.
Bring it in. Take a seat.
They're down by 7. 27 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. 27 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Puts it up from 7. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him. And that hurts as he doesn't get the first one to fall. Trying to focus now on the second.
2 shots.
He's able to hit the second one, and that turns the lead to six. And so they choose to intentionally foul.
No choice but to foul there, but he's probably the last guy you want to see on the line.
But there was no time really to be selective. Stopping the clock was the priority.
Second free throw, no good that time. He really wanted that one. Pass to Winnington. Let's it go with a three. The Pacers pull it in. They've held a 12-point lead early. Outside Mullen. So it's Indiana picking up the win. Probably a little closer than they would have liked it, but a win nonetheless.
Yeah.